Hey folks, we're live again, as promised. So we're back, and we're going to work for at least another hour on our little project here. So if you're joining us on Facebook, if you're joining us on Twitch, if you're joining us on YouTube, welcome. Thanks for joining us. Go ahead and drop me a line in the chat, and let's get started. So we've got our logo here penciled out, and now we're just outlining. Maybe go up a couple notches. And we're going to use our special vector erase tool. Take out the lines inside. Oh, that is not a line to get rid of, but that's okay. Just reattach. Actually, let's just go ahead. Hard time telling what's what. So, okay. out a little bit here so we can get the top knot. Bottom of the helmet. And actually, we need to adjust this one. There we go. And let's make sure these are all connected. Okay, and let's bump this up to 20. Is that the door? Oh. I think it was your mom knocking on Brooklyn's door.
I got a message too. Well, not from Willie, but from Jenna, asking that he was wondering where.
Then let's take this up to 25. No. All layer underneath. Not a roster layer. Vector layer. And change our tool out to the ellipse tool. And we're going to change our color. More like that. Oops. Actually, do it on this layer. Down. Get our erase tool. Get rid of that. Zoom in there. Bollocks. Oh, man. Why did it erase that? And now go back. Okay. Okay, not too bad. Make some adjustments. Let's make sure all of our lines are connected. Yeah. Let's see what happens with the fill bucket. Bollocks. That's okay, though. Okay, we're almost done filling in the armor here. You're almost there. No, that's not the color. Okay. Back out and take a look. Let's do this bit of under armor here. Right. Now we're going to do gradient. Set gradient. Merge those. Let's see. Okay, let's save while I'm thinking about it. That off. Then, oh, my little thingy's not working again. My little Fujitech. Curious. That is so weird. It was working earlier today, and now it's not. Hmm. Well, we'll have to figure it out. So what's supposed to be down here is the logo head of Beyfenn. And every time I talk, it should look one way, and every time I'm silent, it should look another way. But it has literally only worked one time, and that's earlier today. Don't know why. Didn't change anything. Just decided to work. Then decided not to. So, oh well. Anyway, so we've got our... So we've got Beyfenn. We've got our background. And now it's just on to lettering. But for lettering, I'm going to drop this. I'm going to save this as a PNG. Or export this as a PNG. And then we're going to close out of Clip Studio. And we'll do the lettering in Affinity Designer. Pump up our DPI. Create. And import our document, our place. We will place our PNG. Okay. And now we'll go ahead and use our line tool. To create a line for the text. We'll go down to our artistic tool, and we are going to use, we're going to start with Bada Boom. Now, I really don't like the way Bada Boom does on the line, but we're going to try it. And we're going to bump that way up. Up to 24. And we're going to move this. Then we are going to put this under. That in a little bit. Grab the text tool here. And we're going to take our line tool and we'll create another one. Another curve. Grab our node tool. Smooth this out. Okay, now let's grab our tool here. I don't remember how to get that inverted. Actually, do this. Let's go back to the art tool. Actually, we're going to click off the line, grab the art. Ooh. Whoa, our line disappeared. No. artistic tool. Man, I really need to figure out how to do kerning in this. That's better. I like it. I think I like it. And we will export this one as a PNG. Wow. And now, dear friends, we can turn that into a bumper or a sticker or whatever we want to turn it into. So, and that's going to pretty much do it. So, thank you for watching, and we will catch you next time.